upon us, and so indeed is the new millennium. It's right, therefore, that our thoughts are to the future. What will the world be like in 10, 15, 20, 25 years? Will there be roads? Will there be cars? Will there even be petrol to put in them? Who knows? Well, we know, because Top Gear has seen the future. And I'm here to tell you, we're a bit worried. By the year 2005, the government had taxed the price of petrol to a stratospheric 200 euros a gallon. But it didn't stop enthusiasts who sold their houses and lived rough in their cars instead. Petrol was banned and cars were forced to run on gas. Not only did they keep exploding in the street, their new emissions mucked up the geo-environmental sphere, causing volcanic eruptions in Solihull. The Midlands disappeared. But it wasn't all good news. In 2010, there was a national speed limit of a glacial 5 miles an hour.
Morning.
And if you dared to exceed it, armed road police with hidden sensors in the shrubbery were omnipresent. 10 miles an hour was an instant confiscation. 15 miles an hour, a 10,000 euro fine. And 20 miles an hour meant certain deportation to the Bournemouth penal colony. Petrol was only available on shadowy street corners, but you risked everything.
Have you got any petrol?
I have.
I need petrol. I haven't had a drawing for 2 months.
Top quality gear, this. You got the cash?
No, mate, I haven't got it. I'll be good for it.
No deal. Cash or nothing.
Watch,
up front.
I've got a watch. Have me watch.
What do you think this is, Antiques Roadshow?
I can get it.
2 hours.
I'll be back in 2 hours with the cash here. Don't go. Please, don't. I need that petrol.
The government also tried to crack down on the base and sordid practice of car enthusiasts travelling to Thailand to openly abuse an assortment of muscle cars. And Top Gear, forced to go underground, found its stories where it could.
You were right, Quentin. It's a car.
I know. Look, it's big. It's huge.
It is a huge one. Get the boat full of that.
What is it?
It's an Aston. It's an Aston Martin. Is it a Vantage?
It is. Look, it's got a
Okay, listen, everyone. Listen, this is the last of the V8s, okay? This is what people used to drive. Seriously, pay, what was it, Quentin? What did you pay?
You used to pay about 100 quid, I think, to use the road.
I'm driving. Don't spill any.
I can remember driving one of these things from Lincolnshire to Uttoxeter. I had Elgar on before he was banned, you know, and it was just brilliant. How fast is this thing, Tim?
0-60 under 5 seconds. It's just a buzz. I need a fix.
You're getting it. How many horsepower was it?
A massive 600.
600. You all right about that, by the way?
I've lost all sensation, but it doesn't matter. It's worth it. It's wonderful.
How long will I find it?
Contravention of Euro Traffic Directive 645, which means the immediate termination of the vehicle and all of its contents. Sergeant, dispense the law.
But the future was just pretend. Mercifully, we're in the present, where we still have monsters like this. The Dodge Viper GTS, V10, 8 litre, 175 miles an hour and 8 miles to every gallon.
Lamborghini Diablo V12, 4-wheel drive, 202 miles per hour, 6 miles to the gallon.
The 7 litre V12 Lister Storm, 7 miles to the gallon.
And of course the Ferrari 355, you know, 47 cows were skinned so this interior would look nice. Have a great Christmas.